E-type software evolution. In the previous video, we have discussed that Lehman divided softwares into mainly three different categories. So the first category was static type, and it was denoted by S type. The next category was practical type, which is also known as P type. And the last category was embedded type, also known as E type. So in this particular session, we are discussing E-type software evolution. So now let us go for the further detailing. Lehman has 8 laws for this E-type software evolution. So what are the 8 laws are there? The first one, continuing change. An E-type software system must continue to adapt to the real world changes, else it becomes progressively less useful. Change requests will be coming from the client, from the users, and those change requests have to be implemented in the software. Otherwise, in the long run, the software will become useless. Increasing complexity. As an E-type software system evolves, its complexity tends to increase unless work is done to maintain or reduce it. Along with time, the complexity of a software will increase. So you have to do some preventive measures, some actions are to be taken to maintain it and to reduce it. Next one is the conservation of familiarity. So what is the conservation of familiarity? The familiarity with the software or the knowledge about how it was developed and why was it developed in that particular manner, etc. So they are to be preserved and conserved. Must be retained at any cost to implement the changes in the software in the coming days. So all why this particular software has got developed in this way and how it has got developed in this way, all this knowledge must be kept, must be stored, so that this conservation will be required, this conservation of familiarity will be required in the coming days to execute any kind of change request. Continuing growth. In order for an E-type system intended to resolve some business problems, its size of implementing the change grows according to the lifestyle change of the business. So the intended to resolve some business problems. So now you see, its business, the lifestyle, the new wing may get introduced in the existing business. So as a result of that, whenever a particular software is going to implement those changes, the volume of that implementation of change will be directly proportional to the lifestyle change of the business. Reducing quality. An E-type software system declines in quality unless rigorously maintained and adapted to a changing operational environment. Change is inevitable, so change will be coming. So we should be doing continuous maintenance, we should be keeping our software in continuous monitoring and control, so that we can maintain its complexity throughout same. Feedback systems. The E-type software systems constitute multi-loop, multi-level feedback systems and must be treated as such to be successfully modified or improved. So depending upon the feedback obtained, either using multi-loop or multi-level feedback systems, the feedback has to be considered, they have to be analyzed, and the changes are to be brought in the respective software. Self-regulation. E-type system evaluation processes are self-regulating with the distribution of product and process measures close to the normal. That means this particular point is indicating that this particular changes, this aspect follows the normal distribution. Organizational stability. The average effective global activity rate in an evolving E-type system is invariant over the lifetime of the product. So these are the 8 different laws Lehman suggested on this E-type software evolution. Thanks for watching this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.